What's poppin', Grio fam? I'm Chris Witherspoon, and welcome back to theGrio's Weekly Watch, where we're counting down the top TV shows and movies that you should watch this week. I am so excited about this week's list, so let's get right to it. All right, coming in at number three, we have the series finale of the TV show Pose. Have you guys watched Pose this season? Well, don't worry if you haven't, because you only have 6 episodes to catch up on. And let me tell you, each and every episode this season has been hitting. All right, so far we've seen a wedding to end all weddings between Lil Poppy and Angel. Elektra is filthy rich this season with mob money, and the black sitcom queens, Janet Huber, Jack A. Harry, and Anna Marie Horsford united for a special episode that requires you to have every last box of Kleenex on deck. And listen, there's no telling where this finale is gonna take us Sunday night, but right now I'm gonna give you a few receipts on how Pose has shattered a glass ceiling in Hollywood. Now, Pose has the largest cast of transgender actors of color on TV. The show is executive produced by a trans woman of color, Janet Mock. Billy Porter is the first openly gay black man to win an Emmy for lead actor in a TV series. And you know all those terms like Yas Queen, Hunty, Shade, and Reed, like I'm gonna read you for filth. Those all derive from the black gay ballroom scene of the 80s and 90s. But you're hard pressed to hear mainstream media give props to the black gay community. This show does. It's heavy at times, but it's also fierce escapism that we all really need right now. And you can watch the series finale of Pose this Sunday night at 10 p.m. on FX. And coming in at number two, we had the long-awaited release of the movie Gully. Now, getting to this casting, y'all, it stars the Shy's Jacob Lattimore, Jonathan Majors from Lovecraft Country, Kelvin Harris Jr., Travis Scott, and Terrence Howard. Now, Gully tells the story of 3 boyhood friends growing up in LA's roughest neighborhoods. You might be thinking this sort of sounds like Boys in the Hood, but it's nothing like that film. This movie centers around one out-of-control night of partying that changes the lives of these young men forever. Now, folks have been talking about this film since 2019 when it premiered at the Tribeca Film Festival, and after a long delay, you can finally watch it in theaters nationwide today. Now, last but not least, at number one, we have the Debbie Allen Night of Excellence. I'm just joking. It is the Kennedy Center Honors, featuring Debbie Allen, who in my opinion is headlining the show because she's Debbie Allen. Now, the iconic actress, director, choreographer will be honored along with Dick Van Dyke, Garth Brooks, and Joan Baez. The ceremony was delayed for 6 months due to COVID, but it taped last month in Washington, D.C., and Allen has already posted photos looking gorgeous, along with her entire family, who also look insanely beautiful, including her sister, Felicia Rashad, who hosts a portion of the ceremony. Now, mum's the word on who's gonna be performing the tribute for Debbie Allen, but you can rest assured, you guys, it's gonna be a tribute night worthy of a legend. You can watch the Kennedy Center Honors Sunday night at 8 p.m. on CBS. Thanks for checking out the Weekly Watch, and be sure to subscribe for more videos like this.